Hello, gorgeous. Where have you been all my life? Of course I am. I was lucky. If you're gonna be in an accident, that's the best way to be, don't you agree? But then I've always been a lucky guy. I just met you, Miss Drew. I see Maddie's been talking to you about me. Of course it was just an accident. Things like this just happen. I can think of millions. All those jealous husbands and boyfriends of the women who send me marriage proposals, cookies, and other notes d'amour. Oh, please. If a public figure like me went to the police every time someone sent them a nasty gram, the donut shops would lose their best customers. Poison chocolates. Oh dear, Maddie's really gone over the top with this. They were just a bad batch, that's all. Look, if you dare me, I'll eat one. But if we're gonna play that game, I'd prefer another dare. So, how about it, Nancy? Truth or dare? Admit it. You find me irresistible, don't you, Nancy? Oh, you're no fun. Well, mi casa es su casa. You know, my house is your house. Well, feel free to examine the evidence, Miss Drew, while I go off to wardrobe. Have a chocolate while you're at it. Okay, while I go to makeup, stay here, get all cozy, and stay beautiful. Touché! So, you're an old friend of Maddie's. She told me you were coming up to visit. She said you find me irresistible. Don't I know it? She's been driving me crazy worrying about me and these wacky letters I've been getting. Nothing, but she's got her priorities all mixed up. What she should be concerned with is how Powers is driving her career into the ground. My hero, Nancy Drew. You know, according to ancient tradition, if someone saves your life, you should serve them for the rest of your life. So, what can I do for you, young lady? Your wish is my command. Yes, I have. They're named Agent Harris, Officer Josewitz, and Detective Bonnet. It appears I've been quite a celebrity with the local authorities. Hey, I hear Detective Beach is looking for a new star. Do you think I should do some research with my new friends to land the part? Right. Isn't it filmed in Paseo del Mar? That's where you're from, right? No, but I'm willing to take your application for the job. Right, I forgot. You're celebrating your 70th birthday next month? Oh, you are so sassy. But that's what I love about you. Sassy. Hello, Miss Drew. I see you can't get enough of me. Do I drive you wild? Listen, I need to take care of something, but feel free to stick around. Will you do me a favor, though? Dwayne's a loser, babe. Don't tell me he's representing you. Yeah, and that's a problem. Maddie hangs onto Dwayne like my Aunt Mimi hangs onto cats and old newspapers. Yes, he did. A very long time ago. I was young and naive, just like you, love. I made a mistake. Something you can't afford to do at this point in your career. I'll give my agent a call. He can direct you to a decent agent in your league. And just do me a favor and stay away from Dwayne. He's the kiss of death for an actor. Whatever anyone's saying, I can guarantee that it's all wrong. I swear! I'm just misunderstood, that's all. Okay, I admit it. Lillian and I had a brief fling. But my heart's true to you, love. Lillian's a nobody. She was always after me, and things were breaking up between Maddie and me. It was just a rebound romance. Afterwards, it was a rebound relationship. Lillian got to show me around to her friends as her trophy win. And it was fun. For a while. Oh, come on. Everyone knows about Maddie and me. The perfect match made in soap opera land. It was too weird dating her and playing the role on stage. I just had to figure out what was real and what was just an act, you know? I sometimes think, if I can only get out of being Rory Danner, maybe she can get out of being Serena Livingston. I know, I've got this bad reputation as being some kind of Casanova, but everyone's got a second chance, you know? I just wish sometimes I could go back in time, just wake up and find it was just a dream and start all over. I wouldn't be known as Rick the Slick then. Nah, Millie hates me. Did I tell you she's been trying to write me out of the show ever since I got on board? I don't know why. Luckily, owning the company doesn't mean you can work as script writer. Old Millie Strathorn! Heir to the worldwide broadcasting fortune. She's great, except for the fact that she's never liked me. She thinks I'm too big for my britches, and that I wouldn't know a good thing if it came up to me and stuck its finger in my nose.
Yeah, I know Owen. He was with the Beekman Theater, wasn't he? Yeah, he's kind of short and stocky. Oh, don't tell me you're seeing him. Don't break my heart, love. Whoa, you got me there. Can we rewind this and try this one again?
Yeah, right. Prove it.
Okay, Nancy. You got me. I started all of this by sending myself those ransom-style notes. But I had nothing to do with everything else that followed. You gotta believe me. I just did this to get some publicity, not kill myself.
Parting is such sweet sorrow. Farewell, my lady.
Ciao, bella.
Au revoir, mademoiselle.
Rory is a character who is dear to my heart. I never put him in a life-threatening situation. I'll leave that to the writers. Only my hairdresser knows for sure.
Oh no, not while I'm with the WWB Network.
Well, yes, in a sense. I feel like I'm being watched at every moment, and always at the same time. Weekdays from 2 to 3 on Channel 13.
Well, let's just say it was love at first sight.
Entrevue!